Hello, friends. It's time for more Dragon Quest. We're gonna go through these Zwordsrust ruins. I know how to pronounce things, sort of, kinda. Ah, I see. Here's the magical door. Ain't gonna lie, a little disappointed. Oh, is that... Is the orb just gonna be here? Classy clobber for clingy kids. Hammers, I guess. Let's see. The purple orb. Is that really it? Shit, okay. Ooh, honey, we did it. We got the purple orb and it's still in one piece too. If we carry on like this, we'll have the whole set before we know it. I didn't think it would be this simple to just walk in and it's just in a little room like this. What do we have here? What are you? Finds a choker. It has a skull on it. That doesn't look very safe, but I'll take it. Let's see. Oh, it's not an accessory, which is a little suspect. Is it like a helmet, maybe? Oh, maybe it's a... Maybe it's like a gendered... No? It's not a gendered item. Which means it's some sort of special item, so I guess we'll just hold on to it, I suppose. It's probably a quest where someone lost their choker, but that doesn't make any sense, because... Pretty much every quest I picked up, like, the stuff doesn't appear in the world until you actually have the quest in hand. Well, this is kind of... interesting. I'm not really sure where to go.
Listen up, laddie.
Some interesting areas. Near the warriors just in... There was one... Okay, here we go. Thank God, Rap's gonna tell us where to go. Up in a kingdom by the name of Sniffleheim, far north of this wee beach known as the Strand. Okay. Alright, so let's go to the Strand, I suppose. Where's the Strand? There it is. Okay, so he said we gotta go to Sniffleheim, north of the Strand. Hello! Popeye Taylor. That's a name. Whenever I see the name Taylor, I always think of this guy that I went to high school with. His name was Taylor Taylor, and he used to tell us that Dwayne The Rock Johnson was his dad, which I don't believe. Well, you popped in to follow me. That's very cool. I appreciate it, my guy. We're just here to have a good time. Fucking Sniffle. Okay, far to the north could mean just about anything. How far north am I going? Probably into the frosty zone. It's called Sniffleheim. It's gonna be cold, right? Dragon Quest, more like Dragon Breast. You could have done Dragon Rest. Did you do Dragon Rest already, Solar? I need a goddamn Dragon Rest. I'm tired. Oh, no! They won't let me leave. Okay. Alright, Jade's pepped up. We're fine. Hello, it is me. Crasher's here, too. We're going to Sniffleheim, boys. I got the purple orb already. We're on track. We're on track for good things, okay? I don't know how many orbs I'm missing, but I can't be missing that many. I wish every enemy in this game was just someone in a fursuit. When are they gonna make Anthrocon the RPG, you know? What did I miss? You didn't miss much. We only just started. The otter shambles attacks. At least Jade hurts. She hits for 80 when she's pep, which is pretty good. Okay. Should be just a straight shot, then. You can check what orbs you have in the Important Items tab. Yeah, but I don't know how many orbs I have left. That's the only thing. Because it doesn't... Is it going to tell me? I've got... God, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. How many is the total? Like 5, 6? I genuinely do not remember. The open sea north. Disembark in Sniffleheim, hell yeah. There's 6 in all. Okay, so we only need 2 more. That's not a big deal. Listen, I got high hopes for Sniffleheim, if only because I really do like wintry areas. Okay, there's an orb nearby. Hoping this is simple. So, you've sailed all the way across the ocean to visit Sniffleheim, have you? I'm sorry, but your journey has been wasted, I'm afraid. What do I mean? Go and see for yourself. The whole thing is frozen over. Are you telling me that's these people live in the snowy north and they're a little upset that they're extra cold this evening?
Here we are, the Crystal Kingdom of Sniffleheim, home to the famous Blue Orb. It's a fair wee while since I've visited, but it warms my heart to be back.
That must be about the only thing that is warm around here.
She says in like full fursuit.
Let's hurry up and get inside before we all freeze to death.
Nobody in a full fursuit is cold, Veronica. Stop pretending.
Huh?
Capra's here too, hello.
What the? The gates are covered in ice. Look,
I love that she doesn't notice until she's like an inch away from the fucking ice. She's like, whoa, it's icy in here. No way you can see that from like the ship.
How strange. Still, I suppose it's only natural they'd ice up in a climate as cold as this.
Why don't we use Veronica's fire magic to open the door?
But what about all the people inside? How are they supposed to live if they can't get in or out of the city?
It's just an allegory for Corona, really. People are forced to live in here, wear their masks. We can't get in because we don't have any masks.
To keep the main gate free of frost, even in the dead of winter.
So, what are we supposed to do? There's an orb in there we need to get to.
Use your magic to open the ice.
If we can't go in through the front door, we'll just have to head round the back.
Why would the back door be any less frozen than the front? That just seems a little silly. Why not just climb up? Are there no levitation spells? What is this, Oblivion? Hello, Phoenix. Dingo's here too. Why don't we pick up Eric and smash his dumb head against the ice? Also a very good suggestion. I'm gonna be honest, the game's lack of using Eric as a battering ram, I feel like is a big disappointment overall. I just feel like he's right there, you know? We're not missing out on much. I will say, I don't know how useful a hollow object is for battering. I feel like battering needs to be like nice and solid, you know, like a log. Eric is more like he's more like bamboo, you know? Very hollow on the inside. Not much going on between the ears. Gates are frozen shut and the castle is completely silent. What in the world has happened to Sniffleheim? I don't know. They're a little snifflier than usual. You know what's, Oh, they just left this door open. I see. It's a magic key door. Sniffleheim has a alright design. It's not amazing. I think Octagonia was a little more inspired. But this one's kind of okay. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of Dalaran from World of Warcraft. It's a big wizard city that floats around. That way they can reuse assets by moving the city wherever they need it to be.
The whole city's been turned to ice! It's just like what happened to the gates. This doesn't seem natural at all.
She says, smiling at the absolute state of everyone.
This may be the Crystal Kingdom, but it shouldn't be frozen solid, cold winter or no. We'd better take a look around.
Even the horse is frozen. The horse is encased in ice. It looks like it was following after its owner when it was frozen. Oh no, not the horses. Who the fuck builds a castle in the coldest place imaginable? I don't know, Vikings? Cold isn't that bad. I would take being really cold over being really, really hot. Because, like, being hot is just unfucking bearable, dude. Because you can only remove so many layers of clothing. But, like, if it's snowy, you just put more layers on, you know? You, like, start a fire or something. I would rather be in Sniffleheim than Faris, but... I mean, I do like Faris aesthetically better. Just kind of meandering around. Alright, that place is frozen solid. I do like this. Oh! I didn't do that. That wasn't me. Hey! Oh, she's just wearing... I thought she was an elf for a second. I thought she had, like, pointed ears. I was gonna say I might not chat a lot because it's cold and I'm tired, but here I am enjoying the look of my text. Own text as usual, says Dingo. Jesus. Counterpoint. More hot equals more men with their titties out. Okay. Counterpoint. If we're in a super cold area, then it means that the men are gonna have to grow, like, big bar of fat titties, you know, to survive. They need the extra blubber, the extra weight, you know? I'm just saying, if you want some, like, really lithe, twinky men, then yeah, like, Faris is the place to be, for sure. But Sniffleheim, I feel like, is gonna have access to just more naturally born Baras. They need, like, evolution is gonna demand Baras for this area. This lady's okay. She's the only one smart enough to know how to light a fire. Is she the queen or the princess? Take your pick.
Oh, I'm sorry. You gave me a fright. I hadn't expected to see travelers in town.
I'm sorry, why are you reading a spooky
Somebody
grimoire?
Somebody hasn't been turned into a block of ice. Can you tell us what happened here?
Well, it all began 3 months ago. It was a bright, sunny day, just like any other, when suddenly a strange shadow filled the sky. It was a witch.
A witch, you say? Maybe one carrying a spooky black grimoire around town is the only person who's not frozen?
A fairy tale. Just so. She chanted an ancient incantation. And just like that, the town was engulfed in a ferocious snowstorm. The wind took my breath clean away. And before I knew it, I had fainted. And when I awoke, all was frozen. I was the only one spare.
She must be a pretty powerful witch to freeze this whole city with a single spell.
You know, there's like story happening.
I wish I could help, but all this ice is more than my magic can melt.
But I just want to look at my chat and see what people are talking about with the bar of titties. By the way, I want to see if my counterpoint was vindicated or not.
That symbol in your shawl, is that not...
A big snowflake? You telling me they chose a snowflake as their logo?
I haven't introduced myself yet, have I? I am Frisabel, Queen of Sniffleheim.
Frisabel.
You're the queen? So, does that mean the old king is...
I'm afraid so. My father passed away last year. Oh... I've only been in charge these few months, and just look at my kingdom.
I've only been in charge for 3 hours, and everyone's frozen, and one of our snowmen just died. We only had like two of them.
I suppose now isn't a good time to ask about the orb.
I would say now is the perfect time. We ask about the orb, and then we leave.
What kind of orb?
You know.
Why, the big orb. Blue ball that's been handed down in your family for generations, lassie. The truth be told, we need to borrow it.
I'm not gonna lie, Rab kind of came off a little, like, threatening there. Like,
oh,
we were gonna steal it.
You would be welcome to borrow it, but I'm afraid it is locked up tight inside the castle, which is locked up tight inside the ice.
What is with all of these monarchs just
well,
with lending out their super rare shit?
If we don't find a way to melt that ice, we'll never get our hands on the orb.
Like, they don't even know I'm the luminary, or that I'm, like, moderately important.
Rid of that wicked witch, it might break her spell.
Okay, we gotta go beat up a witch. Easy peasy.
I thought just the same thing. Why, only a few days ago, a band of soldiers from a faraway land came here to investigate what was happening.
Those are Heliodor knights, I bet.
I sent them out to try and find the witch and fight her, but I haven't seen them since.
Well... We can't very well leave them out in the cold. Let's go and give those soldiers a hand and bring spring back to Sniffleheim.
I'm gonna be real.
We?
If the soldiers ended up being from Faris and it was like the prince trying to be a good boy knight again, that would be pretty funny.
Oh,
I doubt that's what it is.
Thank
it's almost
you.
Certainly the Heliodor knights being rude
the
again, but
witch dwells in the Hexwood, a haunted forest far to the north of the Sneerfelt steppe.
Ooh, it has one of those little AEs. How foreign to an American such as I.
Alone. She keeps a fierce, magical beast to guard against intruders.
Aye. We'll be sure to keep an eye out. Thanks for the warning, lassie. Aye, come on, boys and girls. Let's head over to the Hexwood.
Alright, let's get out of here. Are you the witch? You have to be. Nobody has a spooky-ass grimoire like that. Haunted forest to the north is a Snarefell step. Am I gonna need to take the boat to get there? See map menu. Map of nearby areas. Let's see. Sniffelheim region. Yeah, we're gonna have to go... We're gonna have to go around and then go through the Sniffelheim region. If it's cold, more men are likely to go into saunas. I often regret never going into the sauna at my college. But, like, at the same time... I don't know. On the one hand, I wouldn't want someone to see my wiener in the sauna, because, like, our saunas at college, you'd go in naked, like, fully. But at the same time, I also almost... I was going to be a nude model my freshman year. And the only reason I didn't do it is because the class was canceled, because not enough people joined. I don't know why I would be fine with people seeing my wiener if I was a nude model, but I wouldn't be fine if they saw it in the sauna. It's the whole peeing into the pool versus peeing while you're in the pool thing. Let's see, the Snarefell, okay. Oh, shit. The horse is right here. Let me grab this. You have saunas in your colleges? I mean, I was gonna say, I don't know how common it is. Our college had a sauna, and I thought that was like a rare and unique thing, but my wife says that her college had a sauna too. So I guess in America, if you just go to college, you get access to free saunas or some shit. My sister's currently in college. I could always just ask her if that's, you know, if that's a thing at her college. Probably not, considering hers is like in the middle of a major city, but you never know. Oh, that looks moderately suspicious way over there. What do we got going over here? Some sort of small little cozy cabin. All right, let me take a look at the map. Yeah, we'll just head straight for the Hexwood, I think. Zoom our way over there. Boy, am I glad they're in there and we're out here and she's the sheriff. The orbs are just taking up space, that's why they don't care about them. Someone renting out a sauna near me for $10 an hour. Just one cackle and that's enough to cast doubt and she's the witch. Yeah, That's kind of how this game operates. Are you a bad guy, or are you a good boy? What in the world is a civilian doing here? The forest is extremely dangerous and advise you to leave immediately. Alright, leave me alone. Let's get through here. Alright, we're gonna have to get all the way up there. Can I just jump over that? I can't. Ah! I've been accosted by a bunch of devious rogues. You know what's fantastic about pretty much all of my audience not being from the United States? Is that none of you guys give a single fuck about the election that's currently happening right now. It's election day today. Which is annoying, because if you go... I'm sure you guys have to deal with this, and I'm so fucking sorry. I absolutely detest that everybody who lives here seems to think that everybody else in the world gives a shit about what we're doing. If you go onto any fucking website, any social media website... Reddit, YouTube, anywhere at all, Twitter. It's just people fucking complaining about the United States election right now. It's so frustrating. As a person who lives here, it's already fucking annoying. And it's gonna be like this for the next, like, week or so. Because the results don't all come in at once, you know? I'd imagine it's even more frustrating for you guys who don't give a single shit about it. You know? I certainly would be annoyed. There we go. It was election day today? Hey, Tony, did you know it's election day? No, I didn't. No, I didn't at all. Gee willikers. Did you know that if the other side wins, that everything falls apart and we're all gonna die? Did you know that? Oh, which side? Oh, the one that you don't like. The one that I don't like. You have to like the one that I like, and if you don't like the one that I like, that means that you're wrong. You have to agree with me. Oh, this guy's all chilly. So cold, my squad were caught in a snowstorm, and before I knew it, I was all on my own. Alright, well. I'm certainly not gonna help you, sorry. Ooh, ice physics. My favorite. Yeah, dude. It's true. In 2003, actually. I was going to say 2013, but no, it was even further back. In 2003, the candidate that I don't like, they farted loudly in a restaurant and didn't say sorry. So if you vote for them, you're voting for Farts McGee, who farted in a restaurant really loudly. Here, let me post about it incessantly on my Twitter. That way you guys all know that I certainly love politics, and I'm very socially conscious, for sure. Because that's the most important thing in the universe, you know? Making sure that the other side doesn't win, and that my side does win. Because let me tell you, living in a two-party system, it's perfect, dude. One side is always wrong, and the other side is always perfect, and if you disagree with that, you're bad. You're a bad guy, and I don't want to hang out with you. Jesus Christ. Can you tell how much I love politics? Can you tell how much I'm enjoying the election cycle? It gets so fun. Ooh, it's great. Nice. I didn't pull aggro from anyone there. You're in a two-party hell, girl. It's lose or lose. I'm actually interested in it, and I wonder how big of an impact would Roe versus Wade's overturning affect the election, but honestly, I don't care much. Election for who, though? Doesn't the president have, like, 2 more years? Oh, no. You don't understand. So, here in America, we have the presidential election, which happens every 4 years. But then, we have 2 other seats of government, right? We have the president, we have the Congress, and we have the Senate, right? And the Congress and the Senate are kind of designed as this, like, checks and balance system where none of them are supposed to have all of the power, right? This idea that the president can do whatever they want is completely false, you know? The president here is the commander-in-chief, meaning they hold control over the military, but they're not, like, fully in control of, like, policy and shit like that. I mean, they have an agenda, of course, but, you know, Congress and the Senate are supposed to do a lot of that. So right now, tons of seats are open in the Senate and Congress. So we gotta vote for those, because they're open. And that's important, I guess. I mean, it is important, right? I poke fun. It is important. But at the same time, it all feels so meaningless, you know? The party becomes separated from the snowstorm. Hey, you know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of that one level in Kingdom Hearts 3. You guys have probably seen the meme where fucking Donald is with you. You're in a snowstorm, it's in the frozen level, and Donald's like, "Getting through this snowstorm will be easy!" And then the snowstorm activates and it fucking flings him like 8 billion feet to his death. It's like into some rocks. It's fucking great. Jor. Oh hey, it's what's his nuts? The Heliodor boy. That's a pretty neat monster design. Sonic Forces came out too. That's also true. That's much more important. Just play Sonic Forces instead.
You will not keep me from the witch beast. Yield!
Hendrik, you're really not as impressive as you think you are. You get knocked back by some little guy.
The Darkspawn, here?
Oof. That's what you get for not paying attention.
How could I be so foolish?
Does he think that I control this beast? Because I definitely don't. This strikes me as one of those, this is gonna be one of those areas where it's, like, a lot of story stuff. Jormun draws near. Yeah, how about I not be, like, literally right next to it? How about that? What abilities do I have? I still don't have the double slash yet, which is kind of annoying. Ooh, a snowball, you say? Oh! No. We're gonna heal back all of that. Fuck you. Thank you. Not all of it, but a decent amount. Happy Sonic Frontiers Day. We also have two separate voting days, I get what you're saying. Actually, Tony, O with the umlaut over it indicates the eh sound and is used in Sweden instead of the clearly superior bleh, wishes it could be. Stop putting unnecessary symbols in stuff. Nobody asked for this, Dingo. Your language just takes perfectly good and normal things that other languages have, and you're just like, let me just put like two dots here. Let me put like a line through this. Who asked? I'm gonna be real. I don't remember contacting the president of Norway and saying, hey, fuck up everyone's favorite letter O. Name a single person who doesn't think O is a dope letter. You fucking can't. It's a dope letter, and you're trying to make emojis real by putting the two dots above it. You're not gonna make emojis real, bro. It's not happening. I won't let you do it. Fuck off. 75 damage. Eat my ass. No wonder Hedrick got his ass whooped. This guy's kind of strong. I genuinely don't know what I would have done in this fight if I didn't have this heal move. The heal move is really fucking good. Yeah, get fucking hit. 78 damage. That's insane. Love being pepped. Get fucked. Oh, no. I needed that. At least I got a shield that works really well. There you go. Actually, Z is a dope letter. That's true. Z is good. X is also good. There's a lot of dope letters out there. Then you have some other letters like K. Who gives a shit about K? Does anybody... Who gives a fuck about K? That's not a very cool letter. Like G? G is an awful letter. I'm gonna be real. Yeah, nice jig, but I'm gonna kill this guy. I don't care how much he buffs himself, I'm fucking killing him. Yeah, there you go. 80 damage on that, too. How much experience do I get for killing that Yorman? 2400 experience. Fucking easy. Great design on this enemy, by the way. No idea why he has bright orange hair in the white tundra, but
your day is done.
Yeah, nice, Hendrik. You really did a lot there, for sure. You definitely deserve the killing blow on that one. Ugh. Yo, Tony, you can make fun of my language as much as you want, but you should be happy that you've never had to look at the Finnish language.
Now it's your turn, Darkspawn. You will not escape me this time!
Oh, we're gonna... I don't think you're capable of fighting me, bud. As long as I have Miracle Slash, there's shit all you can do to me. Oh no! The spooky witch has come!
What is the meaning of this?
What a pleasure to finally meet you, Sir Hendrik.
Ooh, she has a silly little accent too. How exciting.
Damn you, witch.
She kind of looks like Harley Quinn a little bit.
Nothing personal, my pretty, but I promised the one who released me that I'd freeze you in your tracks.
Hedrick is very tall. But either that or she's very small.
Trinket. It's just like his. We shall make such a captivating couple. Matching necklaces and all.
What?
Whoops.
Oh, more questions. You so-called heroes are nothing but talk. It's time to put you two on ice forever.
Wait, let me guess. She's gonna freeze me, but then my luminary symbol's gonna free us. Is that what's gonna happen here?
Not if I have anything to
do with thank God, Veronica's here. Yeah, hit her with a fucking fire blast, Veronica. Fuck yeah, dude. Alright, that's the better of the two outcomes, I assume, would happen. I feel like I should put Veronica in the party, just cause, like,
are you all right?
Fire damage and all that.
Well, now, Sir Hendrik,
You'll be in charge of this party of foreign soldiers we heard about. The ones Queen Frisabel sent. Leaving so soon? Sure you don't want to round us up and throw us in jail?
Rab is such a little shitster.
Oh, I will. All in good time.
Yeah, I'm sure you will, Hendrik. For sure, bud. Capra says that they have a fancy K, which is just a K with a little tilde above it. Not a tilde, but like a fucking apostrophe or whatever.
That spell must have really taken its toll.
On the one hand, I want to make fun of you.
Past a hut on the way here. Let's carry him there.
But I want to give it up to Capra and his area for trying to make K a less shitty letter instead of trying to absolutely bastardize O, one of the best letters in the language. I'll find any way to make fun of Dingo's language, and I will raise up other shitty languages just to shit on Dingo's language. You can't fucking tell me that I can't. Oh, that's fun. You can see the deer out there. That's kind of cute. This bitch is still in her pajamas. Funny little peepa. Hendrik straight up drop kicks Rab after that. I don't think Hendrik could lift himself with how heavy that armor is.
Ah, so you are finally awake. Are you feeling better, friend?
Who is this very suspicious man? Let's say no.
Is that so? Then rest by the fire a while. The warmth would do you good. When your friends brought you here, you were frozen to the core.
I do not like this man. He's very suspicious.
Ah, but forgive me. I have not introduced myself. I am Snorri, scholar of the arcane arts. I came here to investigate the origins of the Wicked Witch who froze Sniffelheim solid. It was luck, and luck alone, that caused me to be away from the city when she first appeared. Or I, too, would have been turned into an icy statue. Your friends tell me the Queen has asked you to eliminate the sorceress. If it will help you in your quest, I will be happy to share what I have learned.
I know that this isn't going to happen.
His name is Kristallinda.
Kristallinda, spelt Crystal, like a stripper version of Crystal. Very cool.
A mighty mage imprisoned her within the pages of an enchanted grimoire. The book was hidden away safely in the Royal Library, an ancient archive built by the founders of Sniffelheim to
Alright, well, this is a boring backstory.
I tried to go and see the book for myself. Alas, the library was swarming with monsters, and I was forced to retreat.
Hell yeah, Veronica's here to throw more fireballs and be obnoxious.
Hello. Up and about, are you? Thank goodness for that.
Indeed. You are well on the way to recovery thanks to your young friend here.
This man speaks too slowly for me to be happy.
Veronica cares for you very deeply.
Put a sock in it, Snorri!
There is no need to be embarrassed, my dear. Anyway, your timing is perfect.
All right, tell me more about the witch, I guess.
To the point, then. We're taking Snorri here back to the library so he can look for clues on how to beat her.
It is high on a plateau to the east of here, but we must make our way around to the south before...
Go to the east, go through the south, go east. Okay. What I would love to happen at this point is through interacting with Snorri, being that he's some sort of, like, wizard, it'd be pretty neat if we could talk to him and maybe the Luminary could learn some spells that would... I don't know, like, just make him a little more magic-focused, you know what I mean? Okay, so we gotta go to the Arborian Highlands, and then we'll... Oh, no. No, I see. I see. The Royal Library is to the right. So we just need to loop around there. We don't actually have to change zones. Usually they make you do that. But it'd be cool if we could talk to Snorri and he would, like, teach us some magic. And then you could kind of build the Luminary as a mage or, like, a healer if you wanted. It just kind of irks me when you have an RPG and you don't really get to pick, like, what the character's stuff is. At least if they're supposed to be a blank slate. Like, Ichiban is built in a very specific way on purpose. And that's, you know, that's fine. Right? Like, that doesn't bother me. But the Luminary, again, is like such a blank slate. It'd be pretty cool if we'd be able to do something with that. Okay, we need to get up there. That's the only thing. How am I gonna get up there? Go around the south, maybe? And then... Oh, let me loot that crystal, actually. Pupo can unlock skills in the skill tree. Yeah. He's more of a scholar than a magic user. They should have made him more of a magic user. It'd just be neat if we could just meet people that, you know, taught us some more stuff. Oh, I guess I have to go to sleep. There we go. I'm trying to, you know, gotta make sure I pick up these camps before we leave. I like N and L and their fat counterparts. Excuse me? Capra, those aren't letters. You're just putting weird shapes in my chat. Who gave this man permission to bastardize my chat with his disgusting forward and keyboard? Terrible. Awful. Oh, hello. Is that some sort of big worm stuck in the ice? It is. It's a big dragon stuck in the ice. A giant frost worm, if you will. Alright, let me figure out which way we gotta go. How the fuck do I get up there? That's the real question. Anyone wants to play Oblivion so bad, I can tell. I always want to play Oblivion. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm enjoying Sniffleheim so far. It's not bad. It's definitely better than Gondolia, for sure. That was one of the worst levels by far. But this one's fine. It's a little less straightforward, which I appreciate. Am I not? Okay. I'm trying to figure out how to get up there. Oh. Let's try going this way. This guy has a great design. It makes no sense that he's here. Why was he not in the Hawaiian-themed area? Why the fuck is he here in the tundra? You know what? I should kill this guy. I'm gonna kill this guy because I want to see what his mount does. Maybe that'll help me out here. A frist worm, perhaps. Oh. Absolutely just demolished. Jesus Christ. Jade is great. She deals so much damage. I love her. She deals damage and she has fat titties? How could you say no to that? Oh god. Face Invader. Terrible name. Awful. She hurts everything. Oh, apparently I do too. Very cool. Eric is... He's losing his luster. Well, he dodges really well. His boomerang isn't that great, but like... His spells are really good. Bites the dust. No, I don't use my skill points. You can now ride the Face Invader. Let's see what he does. Is he one of those attacking ones? Those are boring. Oh, he is. He's just one of those big attacking ones. That's fine, I suppose. Do I get experience for that, though? Ah! Okay, I'm not strong enough to charge through that, so what's even the point? I see. There was ice that I could break back there. I'm gonna turn around and we'll do that. I remember seeing a big block of ice. I'm sure I can break it. Oh my god, dude. I need to level up her charm a bit with skill points. Her charm move is a little lacking. Are these guys made of metal? They have to be made of metal. Hold on. There's no way he's not. Oh. Apparently he's not, because that dealt absolutely poo-poo-ass damage. Thanks, Rad. Appreciate the heal. She doesn't even need, like, a special ability or anything. She just attacks and it hurts real bad. Yeah, using my regular-ass sword is just better than the Metal Slash. Stupid dumb. You should respec him into knives. I could. Or I could just swap him for Silvando. I don't mind his like, the AoE style that I have him set up with now. I really don't mind it at all. It's just, he's really just not as useful on stuff that isn't, like, a boss fight, you know what I mean? I should probably give him some more AoE spells. Where was it? I could have sworn I saw like a big ice block around here somewhere. Oh, you know what? That's right, the dragon was over. Maybe I can burst that dragon out. This seems like a terrible idea. I'm gonna try it though. Just to see if I can. And then I think that, yeah, there was a rock here. Aha, there we go. With a big, ugly ass, disgusting giant. Let's go this way. I'm sure he's very nice. I'm sure that he's a very nice man, but I have no interest in interacting with him. Can I go down? There's, nothing here that I can see. Oh well. Is the giant my reward for coming here? Maybe he dropped something good. I don't see anything in the ice. I don't even think it'll let me down there. Remove the bimbo and bring back the Jolly Jester. I hope you're not referring to Jade as the bimbo. I hope you mean Eric. Because Eric is very much a stinky himbo. Ah, here we go. There's that crystal I wanted to loot. Platinum ore and a blue eye and some more platinum ore. Okay, cool. That makes it worth coming this way. Everybody wants Eric to be gone. Get rid of Eric. He smells. I might just get rid of Eric. I mean, don't get me wrong. His outfit is absolutely stellar, and Sylvana's outfit kind of sucks weenies. But like, oh, I can't break the frost worm out of his prison. All that work getting this guy just for him to break one little fucking stone? Stupid. Dumb. That's fine. Let's rush back to where we were, though. The people demand the clown. Unlike Jade, Eric has no brain. Maybe now I won't put the clown back in. Maybe now I won't put Silvando in the party ever. Just to spite all of you. If I can't have fun, then no one can have fun. I'm the streamer, which means I have to have all the fun all the time, and you guys don't get to have any fun. I found a mini medal. Very cool. Let's go this way. So, like I said in the Discord server, every time I stream this game, it is a toss-up where it's like every other stream, I'm either having a very good time playing this game or I am having a very bad time playing this game. And I have never, I shouldn't say never, but it is difficult for me to remember a time where I've been so pulled back and forth on a video game. Normally I can tell if I dislike a game within the first like hour or two, you know, just through pure experience alone. But this one is such a toss-up and it's so inconsistent. With some levels absolutely shining, while others are just, they almost feel half-baked. Like, they're just put in there to draw out the game time. So, we're gonna play a bit more of this, and my idea was that by Friday, when I do the longer stream for this game, because this one's good, today's gonna be a little shorter. Friday is Veterans Day here in the US, so I have that day off, and I have a bunch of stuff planned, but because I won't have to worry about work, we're gonna go ahead and play this game for a while. But Crash informed me that he thinks I should get to Yggdrasil, at the very least. Because he says that's the turning point of the game. But, like, we'll see. We'll see. Pray that Sniffleheim doesn't, you know, bore me. So far, this level's fine. It's pretty standard. You to the HR department. Is having fun 50% of the time worth it? The big boy questions. I don't know. See that? Up! This fucking sneaky ass statue! That's pretty fucking fun. Now. Getting caught out. Oh! This enemy is good. I enjoy this enemy. Come on, Jade. Absolutely body this man. I have so many games that I could potentially play. I was thinking I might put it up to a vote for you guys. Oh shit, that's a lot of damage. I hope Jade can knock him over. Oh, it doesn't even matter, I'm just gonna crit him to death. That's fine. Pooh crits a lot. A little slime friend. Hello. Goo-wee! You're the first Gooman to have visited this place in a long slime. Welcome to the Royal Library, home of the greatest collection of the books in all of Erdia. Since you've come all this way, I'll tell you something really useful. This building's like a puzzle box. When you press the ghouling switches, the walls and staircases spin around and you can goo to different places. But first, you gotta press the big Gurian button next to me. That will activate the switches so you can actually use them. Once you press this button, keep your eyes peeled to the other ghouling Gurian switches. There's what? Okay, alright. I thought this looked suspicious when I started talking to him. A big puzzle, you say? That's perfect for someone like me who reads his chat 50% of the time, so he doesn't actually pay attention to the puzzles and switches. Why have fun 50% of the time in the game when you could have fun 100% of the time in Paper Mario? That's true. I could play Paper Mario. I haven't played it in a few years. I used to play it all the time. I would do a replay of it once a year. And then I want to say maybe like 5 or 6 years ago, I stopped doing that. So I'm curious if it still holds up. I've always said that it was one of my favorite games, if not my favorite game, it depended on when you asked me. But then there's other stuff that's coming out. On the 17th of this month, Warhammer 40K Darktide comes out, which is like a cooperative shooty-up game, you know? And I was thinking of streaming that for funsies. I think that one will have Twitch integration too, so you guys can like vote on having strong enemies beat the shit out of me, which would be pretty fun. Oh, hello. Talk, 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 you've clocked me, haven't you? Please don't eat me, I don't taste very good. Just act like you never saw me. Just a second. You're the luminary, aren't you? Oh, praise the one who controls the clocks. But what am I waiting for? The password I found is... Stinky. That's the password. You can now visit All Trades Abbey via the Altar of Revelry, blah, 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 blah. Let's get going. Oh, a spooky ghost, you say? I'll have you know, October is over and Halloween is done. No, thank you. Crash is gaslighting you every time you decide to quit. It always starts. You have to reach this point and then the goalpost is moved until you're at the very end, max level. To be fair, this is the first time I said to get to a specific part. Usually I just said later. I don't think you're gaslighting me, Crash. I think it's very clear that this game has its fans, right? And those fans are very passionate about it. People like Crash, people like Ironic as well. He seems to really like this game. Clearly, there are people who really like this game. And they try to encourage other people to enjoy it and like it in the same way that they do. And I don't know if I'm gelling with it, quite frankly. But maybe. Maybe if I keep going. It's a tatty old book entitled A Storm from the North. Pooh Butt takes it from the shelf and has a closer look. Immediately identifiable by their fierce and blood-curdling war cry, the vicious Vikings are known for many as the Okay, it's a book about Vikings. I don't care about that. I wanted loot. We're gonna get to the Yggdrasil and he's gonna say, you gotta get to level 75 before the game gets good. If we get to Yggdrasil, by that point I will have made a decision. If we get to Yggdrasil and the game is stinky doo-doo-ass trash, then we're not going to keep going. But if some sort of big twist happens and I'm super involved and like, invested in what's going on, then yeah. I'm hoping we find some loot in here. Instead, we're just getting... I wouldn't even call this lore. It's just flavor text, really. Alright. I've explored everything. Let's hit the switch here. I mean, so far, I wouldn't really call this a puzzle. It's more just stuff activating, and I'm going in a straight line. Like, a puzzle would imply that I have to think about what I'm doing, you know? Maybe if we just get to the Silvando sex scene, it'll get good. What if Silvando has sex with a woman to troll us? Oh, no. I'm sorry. Who's this... wizardly scholar? What is this, fucking Dragon Tales? I do like the monsters in here, though. They have very cute designs. I don't like that they're extremely wide. Fucking wide Putin memes walking around here. I'm tempted to kill that little dragon, but at the same time, I'm trying to avoid combat just so we can speed our way through here. The monsters seem very nice, though. They're just straight up not attacking me at all, which is cool. I don't want to say we're friends, but at the very least we're acquaintances if they're just gonna let me meander around here. Alright, wait for this guy to go a bit. There we go. Cry. So I was thinking of doing Darktide. There's Paper Mario, as I discussed. There's another game that I want to play called Judgment, which I've not played. Uh-oh, it's a Mimic! There we go. I like the Mimics. I think they're fun.
Get him, Eric.
The best part about a Mimic is when you beat it and you get some wacky loot that you wouldn't have, you know, otherwise gotten. It's always going to be something, like, really silly and weird.
Here you go, laddie.
Heal me up, big guy. A Mimic could have any- Oh my god! A Mimic could have anything in it! Please, Rap. Please heal me. I'm kind of playing with fire, just allowing- Yeah, there we go. Drain magic. Oh no, not 9 magic. Whatever will I do? That's such a large amount of magic. Uh-oh. Yeah, get fucked. Get out of here. I was hoping he'd hit Rab. Oh, by the way, I gotta show you guys Serena. I leveled her up a little bit. Like, I put her talent points in. I've come to terms with the fact that she's absolutely just gonna... Oh, God. She's just gonna be better than Rab all the time for healing. Like, Rab can't even compete, and I'll show you why.
Another one bites the dust.
In the chest. Ooh, a seat of skill. Yeah, let me show you her. Notice anything different? She's got 2 fucking staffs. Little wands. She can dual wield now, which is pretty impressive. Whereas Rab is kind of just stuck with the cane. I mean, maybe I can make him dual wield later, but like... Oh shit, why does he have his doo-doo ass cane? Why did I never give him this one? The better one. Well, let me check out those, anti-freeze earrings. Reduces ice damage. What does this one do? Well, it's the same as the concrete earrings. I just need to do this, I suppose. There we go. Handy heal all. Oof, Judgment is long, but also good. Judgment is really good, especially if you like tailing missions, of which there are like 30. Well, remember, I was complaining in fucking Yakuza Like a Dragon that there was no tailing missions after they introduced them, so, you know, maybe having some tailing missions would cheer me up. Like Assassin's Creed tailing? Oof. Nah, like different tailing. It's, you know, it's Yakuza chasing people in the streets tailing. Less stealthy Assassin's Creed boring tailing. Alright, let's hit this up. One of my favorite games is Vermintide 2. I thought maybe I'd stream that. Not as like a series, but just for fun one of these days. As like a one-off thing. Instead of a Dead by Daylight weekend, I just do Vermintide. Vermintide is fun because it has Twitch integration. So like I said, you guys can vote. That one's horrible though. Because you guys can vote to absolutely just fuck me sideways if there's nothing I can do about it. Straight up, there's a vote that you can do in that game. That just allows you guys to spawn bosses, and there's shit all I can do about that. Like, you could just spawn 8 of them, if you wanted. And that's not very fun for me. I mean, it's kind of fun for me, but the character I play is built to kill bosses, so that's kind of useful for me. But certainly, my party is not going to enjoy that. I can tell you that. If you ever play Judgment, stay away from a guy called Kim. Tony just wants to pretend it's not bad. Tailing at this point. No! Tailing missions are fun in Yakuza. It's, you know, when there's not like 8 billion of them in a row. Tony, have you seen Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared, specifically the TV show? I haven't seen the show, no. I have so many shows on my watch list right now. I'm currently finishing Better Call Saul. And that's taking a lot of time. Because it just is. So that's why I haven't really been... Then I want to watch the Cyberpunk anime... But Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared, the TV show is on my list, I promise. I mean, I loved the YouTube series. I thought it was really cool and interesting. I remember I showed it to, like, everybody I knew.
This should be very useful indeed. It is the great mage's account of how he imprisoned the witch in the grimoire. Let's see now.
I'd like to point out that there truly was no puzzle here. I just hit every switch in the order that they appeared, and the only reason I got lost for a second there was because I didn't go far enough. That's on me. Conquer nor constrain her.
And so I did conspire with a great enchanted beast that by its incorporation of a piece of the witch's magic, I might by my small strength subdue her.
Is it the dragon? It's the Frost Wyrm, isn't it?
The witch imprisoned in a book and laid to rest in the Royal Library of Sniffelheim. As for the beast, it haunteth the nearby Hexwood to this day. I see. So, even the greatest mage of the Age of Heroes needed the help of a magical creature to seal the witch away.
A great enchanted beast? Well, you certainly met one of those in a Hexwood. That thing that was supposed to be the witch's pet.
That...
Oh? Tell me, what did this creature look like?
Yorman was the big creature? That guy was fucking stupid. I beat him by myself.
White body with a golden mane, two pointed tusks jutting from an enormous jaw.
Are you serious? You're telling me that this thing, that's the guy? No way.
How can you have been so foolish? The monster you defeated was the very same one that kept a part of the witch's power sealed away.
Well, maybe he shouldn't have fucking attacked me, and maybe he shouldn't have been so weak that I could just defeat him by myself without the rest of my party.
It's not his fault. Queen Frizabel told us it was on the witch's side. She said it guarded her against intruders.
Queen Frizabel's a lying bitch.
True? But why would her majesty say such a thing?
Because she's evil. She snickered that one time.
I'm sure I've seen that symbol somewhere before. Wasn't it on the front of the book the queen was reading when we first met her?
Ooh, spooky.
This? Why, this is the Sorcerer's Seal. It is a ward placed on all the forbidden books of the Great Library.
I feel like marking all the forbidden books with the
Which
same symbol is probably going to make it easy for people to, like, find them and read
forbidden.
Them.
Wait, what if it was the book the witch was sealed away in? What if...
She is the witch.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
We need to go back to Sniffelheim and talk to the queen. I've got a feeling there's some funny business afoot.
Fucking Garfield telling us there's some funny business afoot. That's the real funny business here. You should stream whatever one-offs you want. It could potentially be very fun. Maybe. I've been thinking about doing more one-off things. My plan with streaming is pretty much this, right? I've been enjoying the format we've been doing, right? Where I have two main games running, you know, at the same time. And I will stream those throughout the week, you know, during the week. And then on the weekends, I'll do, like, Dead by Daylight with Dingo and Capra, which is always fun. Because the two of them are very handsome and fun to play with. But, you know, I can always transition those weekend days into doing some one-offs. I think doing a one-off stream every now and again is a fun little idea. I can play some of the games that I would never really do as full streams, things like Vermintide, where I would just kill rats, maybe, you know, Darktide, stuff like that. Ooh, is it a mimic? Nah. Molten globules. I'll just put that away, I suppose. So I was thinking of maybe workshopping that idea around, who knows, maybe I could play Sonic Frontiers or Persona or something. Plus, it also gives me a chance to talk with you guys. I could continue doing Chill Vibes, which, by the way, I bet you guys thought I forgot that I did that. I didn't. But my plan with that was always to do it with Stefan, but the guy is too busy. I can't. I mean, I could do it alone, but at that point, I should just do one-off streams if I want to talk with you guys. I think that's a bit more interesting, if you ask me. But Stefan is too busy for me to do things with him, unfortunately. Sniffleheim City. The guy is absolutely unreachable. Because he works a job, and he's also going back to school. That's why I don't have any time to hang out with him. Because he's going back for his fucking... Actually, I don't think he's doing his master's. His wife is doing her master's, and she's gonna finish soon. He's just going back for a different type of degree. He's going for, like, computery stuff, which is so fucking time-consuming. I feel bad. He doesn't have as much time to do fun stuff as he'd like. Him and his wife are so busy. They are busy, busy people, and they're always doing such interesting stuff. His wife works at a cat, like, rescue place, and she's, like, the most qualified employee they have, so they lean on her for everything. They always have, like, 8 billion cats in their house because they're always fostering them, like, for the clinic. So already they're busy there. They just got a dog, too, on top of that. They rescued a stray dog, essentially. So they're busy people. So that's why I don't do fucking Chill Vibes anymore. Because my next plan was I was going to watch the Linkara movie with him. We were going to watch the Linkara movie and shit on that for a little while, because it's pretty bad. But, you know. Unreachable boy. Oh no, the ice is getting worse. That's not good. I can't believe my mother finished Better Call Saul before Tony. I finished Better Call Saul and I really liked it. I'm glad. I really like Better Call Saul too. I'm on season 5 right now. I'm like halfway through. It's really good. I've always loved Breaking Bad, and Better Call Saul has always been stellar as well. I still think I like Breaking Bad more, even though I'm getting towards the end of Better Call Saul. But Saul is still fantastic. I could definitely see how people would say, you know, I prefer Breaking Bad or I prefer Saul. I think it really comes down to how, God, my fucking... I put on new shoes and I'm slipping around on my fucking floor. I think it comes down to whether or not you want to enjoy watching Walter, who's just objectively a bad person, and you get to see him, like, fail. Or how much you like watching Jimmy McGill become Saul Goodman. He's such a good guy who just becomes Saul. It's so interesting. It's fun. I could definitely see an argument for both. I think personally I prefer Breaking Bad, but both are stellar.
Oh, there you all are.
Plus it's Stefan. Stefan's so married. Damn, safe. Now what'll I do?
I was so awfully worried about
Stefan's
you.
Been married I since he was like 15. Stefan and his wife have been dating since they were very young. So
Your Majesty.
The being married thing is just a formality. He's basically been married to her since forever. I love the two of them. They're both yes, fucking slap her, Veronica. Hell yeah.
I knew it.
They're both such stellar people. I love them a lot.
You got when I hit you with my fireball. Mm-hmm. You're not the queen at all. You're the witch.
I'd like to point out that Veronica's fireball is on her fucking neck. What a good target. Veronica's ruthless. Like, she didn't just shoot a body shot. She shot for her fucking neck. That's... Imagine a fireball blasting your neck open, just exploding your head off. That was Veronica's plan this whole time. I just like to point that out here. Oh no, it's the evil witch.
What in the... Her Majesty was Crystalinda all along.
Yeah, now we're gonna beat her because we're way stronger than whoever imprisoned her before.
Thank you so much for taking care of that pesky power plunderer for me. Now I'm bursting with energy again, just like old times.
Hear me out, guys.
And I believe we
Rab has sex with her. Business. And then she just leaves. Satisfied. She leaves satisfied.
But you won't get away so easily.
I know the spell to seal her away again, but it won't work while she's at full strength. If you can weaken her, I'll see what I can do.
I mean, I like this. I like the idea that we're not strong enough to beat her and we need someone to, like, seal her away. That's far more interesting than us just beating her because we're cool. Also, I think she was supposed to be talking there because her lips moved, but nothing happened. Please don't. I'm a snowman! That's kind of a lot of damage. Let's see here. Let's hit her with that big fat earth damage. Jimmy definitely has more humility than Walt. Seven has been married since the beginning of the universe. Him and his wife are very cute.
Feeling chilly.
I would love if Rab could heal me. That would be epic and fun. It just hurts all of them. I guess we'll just attack. I broke free. Hell yeah. Let's use Miracle Slash. Oh shit, I should use the Flame Slash. But I do want to heal myself before anything happens here. There you go, Rab. Heal me up. Heal me up. I'll hit her with the Flame Slash. That's probably... I don't want to be a snowman again, please. Oh god, what is she doing? Where is Jade going? She's just waddling forward. Jade and her fellow party members' attacks are not... Oh shit, I didn't get to see. I didn't get to see what the debuff was. Uh-oh. I assume it has something to do with visibility, right? Less likely to hit her, maybe? I mean, it's a snowstorm, so... She still has the debuff on her. I missed, but you know, it didn't? My big fucking... Oh my god, 71 damage. That's so much fucking damage. Alright, okay. Alright. Let's see what we got here. Most spells and abilities for free for a few turns. MP is no objects. That's not really useful because we don't have a mage on our team, really. Alright, I'm gonna heal myself. No, that's not good. Please don't miss. I don't know if you can miss the heals. I don't think you can. There we go. Ooh! Oh, that's like all my fucking health. That's really bad, actually. That's like really fucking bad. We might actually lose. I might have to put Serena in the party. Shit. This is 30 health. Wow. Oh my god, stop. Ooh, this isn't bad though. Now that he's pepped. Okay. Scorches a single enemy with a burning blade before relieving them of their valuables. No. Guard fire and earth attacks. Scorched earth. Fire and brimstone. Yeah, we want this one.
Here we go!
There we go. With her resistances down. Hopefully my attack. Yeah, there we go! Look at that fucking fat damage! Please don't attack. Please don't. Oh, you fucking fat bitch! Ugh. Alright, Rab will heal himself, and hopefully Kuba can get rezzed soon. Okay, let's hit her with Boulderbringer. Look at that fucking damage. Insane. Not gonna lie, she's kinda hot. She's mid. She's pretty hot, I'd say. Let me see here. Is there anything I can do to help my party? I don't think so. I think just Rab needs to keep us alive here. Fuck it, I'm just gonna Flame Slash her. Oh, that's not worth using on her at all. Oh, please. Oh no, don't pep yourself. Don't attack me immediately, please. You've been made more vulnerable to ice. Heal me, Rab, please. Thank you. Thank God. As long as Boulderbringer is still on her, I think we have a chance here. Please don't just one-shot my party right now. Oh my god. Whew, she's spreading her damage around like a fucking moron. Thank God.
ring.
Oh, no, no, no. I think Eric might die here. No, he got very close, though. Oof. Oof. Do I burst her down? I'm gonna try. Boulder Bringer.
Safety first.
Alright, Poobot is still alive, which is pretty alright. Ugh. Let's see. No, I think we're gonna be okay. See, I need something. Okay, we'll just use a regular old attack. 54 damage is nothing to scoff at. Oh shit, she missed. She's definitely gonna kill Eric, though. And Rab, that's bad. That's okay. Jade's pepped up. Jade might be able to finish this with her fat hitting attacks. Especially with the- oh, okay. Alright, hold on. Hold on. A shockwave that assails all enemies. Honestly? It might be better just to let them just attack normally. I think we'll get more value.
No!
Hey, there we go. Easy. You guys were worried? We're hurting real bad. Oh, we're dead, says Capra. Yeah. Yeah, get fucked. I'm playing at a disadvantage, too. You know, I'm not farming levels or nothing. That's just pure skill, baby. I don't even have Serena in my party. Rab is good enough for me. He does a fine job. I like that Veronica is useful here. It'd be kind of stupid to go to the ice zone and have them not use their fire mage in the party. I'm glad that someone on the writing team was like, let's have Veronica do stuff.
Fell and feller. Fabula ferocious.
This is some like Disney Merlin-esque shit for these spells.
Stop it. Please, anything but that.
Hey, how about when we seal her, we burn the book with her inside when we're done? Then this shit can never happen again.
Skelter, bind, and belter, anima atrocious, liba, claustra.
Got a belter, boys.
Hex.
You heard him. Get out your belts, ladies and gentlemen.
I wonder how this word is pronounced.
We're gonna send her away. We're gonna fucking. We're gonna belter the. It's time.
Yes, I remember now. Liber claustra. Hexbialidosus!
Get him! Get him, Snorri! Crack the Get her with one last. Let me get her with another belt crack, make sure she's extra stuck in there. There we go.
Please forgive me! I'll do anything! I'll change my ways, I promise!
I don't think anybody believes you. Get in your fucking book, get out of here! I'm gonna band off Twitch for taking my belt off and cracking it. It's too sexually suggestive.
Look! The ice! It's melting!
Yes, thank you, Serena. Thank you for once again spouting exposition and nothing else. Very epic of you. The spooky ice is gone.
Wait for me! That's what I saw coming
out, Chad. Hey. I love that every village has the same, like, four NPCs. And the same outfits, too. Like, regardless of the climate, they're just always there. Really getting the good use out of those assets, for sure. Excuse me. Are you the original mage, Snorri? Is that... I'm sorry, was Snorri the queen this entire time? Is that what's going on here?
Your Majesty, is it really you?
How come she teleported back? Did she trade spots? Oh, I get it. She traded spots with her. That must be what it is.
I remember now. The witch trapped me in that book and pretended to be me, didn't she?
The belt doesn't give second chances. All that you do is too sexually suggestive.
Fear not, your majesty. The witch is sealed away once more.
All you guys tried to get trans representation from Snorri. It's not happening. Snorri is a Sigma male. He would never be Queen Isabel, or Frizzabel, excuse me. To
the
castle.
The Chancellor is beside himself with worry.
What are these accents? This area has such weird accents.
Thank you so much for saving my kingdom. I must see to it that
I'm fucking tired rewarded. Of the gays and the trans reward, don't you? Trying to steal all of my old age zaddies from me. Snorri is ours. Okay? Gladly give it to you. It's not gay for me to want to have sex with Snorri. That's perfectly straight, and I'm tired of you guys trying to take that away from me. Fuck you. Maybe if this were June, maybe if it was Pride Month. But it ain't. Snorri's ours. I'll fucking... I'll belt all of you fuckheads if you fucking... Hold on, the belt's stuck. I'll belt all you fuckheads if you try to steal Snorri from me. I don't think I won't. And it won't be fun. Like this, your cock won't go through. It'll be like your neck or something. Like the 1950s in here. I'll let you keep hold of this. His name is literally Snorri because he's so boring in bed. I got the witch's grimoire. All this story shit is happening. I'm not fucking paying attention to any of that. I'm assuming we have to go inside and talk to the queen or whatever. It's fine. Let's go back to the church. Go ahead and, Let's see what I got for points. Ooh, do I have enough for the spell? Was it 6? Oh, it was 16. Damn it! Veronica, all your shit's too expensive too. That's fine. We'll just save it here. There we go. That was a fun little area. I liked that area. That was a fun one. That was a good use of my time. For sure. I didn't feel like my time was wasted or anything there. His name is literally... I wish he was the queen even if it didn't make sense. Belt me. He's 247. Zam. God. I want that meme to come back. I fucking love... She's dead. She's 15. Zam. That fucking meme is so stupid and dumb and bad, and I love it. It's so fucking dumb. I can't wait for it to come back in a few years when that creator does some stupid shit and gets canceled on YouTube again. Gets canceled again, I should say. You can't really make a damn she's 15 Zam video on YouTube and then not get canceled at least once. You know what I mean? But I hope you guys had a good time. Thanks for joining me. I think I'm gonna call it here. We can, you know, completed the zone to the best of my... Oh my god, this fucking guy. This guy looks like Dragon Quest Shaggy. I love it. Norville. But I hope you guys had a good time. I will see you on the next one. We're gonna have Oblivion tomorrow, and then on Friday we will be back for more Dragon Quest. And then the weekend we'll have Dead by Daylight, which is always fun with Capra Indigo. Hope to see you guys there, and if I don't, just have a good rest of your night. See you guys next time.